Hello friends, I'm Dr. Aymatullah, working for Government College of Engineering in Bargu, the Department of Mechanical Engineering. I'm here to present you a Japanese technique called 5S. It is one of the famous techniques hugely followed in various industries. This technique is started taking its roots in India, particularly in small scale industries. Every industry or every organization will encounter certain problems specific to their industry. A small scale industry will normally encounter this problem like disorder or contagious environment. If you see any small scale industry, everything will be arranged in a haphazardly manner, which leads to mistakes in the component manufacture, and process errors will also be encountered, which leads to demotivated employees because they are answerable for any product loss or any mistakes in the product, and which also will take you to higher absenteeism during the working time. For all these problems, a 5S can solve, which is a housekeeping technique. We will see what exactly 5S principle talks about. Here 5S stands for 5SSS. So here we are going to learn a few Japanese terminologies. Each terminology is specified in English translation. Here Seiri, Seiten, Seisu, Shikitsui and Tritsuki, which stands for 5S's, which is nothing but Seiri talks about sorting out the processes, sorting out the products which are really required or not required, and Seiten talks about orderliness. Saiso is a cleaning. Seikutsu talks about standardization of the process. Shitsuki, which talks about sustaining and the discipline of the process. We will see one by one. Seiri, here these are the steps we are going to follow. First we have to decide what you need. In the sense, what are the products which are really needed for the working process. Even if you see your room, some of the products are highly useful, some of them are very rarely used, some items may be used once in a year, so that we are going to segregate these items according to our use. So in Seiri, we are going to decide what you need. In the second step, we are going to remove unnecessary clutters and all tools, gauges, materials are classified and then stored. Here we are going to remove items which are broken, which are rarely unusable or occasionally used. For effective segregation, we have a red tag technique. This is commonly used in industries. What here we do is, we are going to red tag the products which are really unnecessary for a period of time. So in this technique, we are giving red tables to staff. We are going to ask staff to go through every item in the workplace. We are going to ask if needed those that are needed in what quantity, and not needed, red tag it. Even if you see our workshop, we have a number of components which are lying unusable for a number of months. Probably that can be isolated from the workplace so that the cleanliness can be maintained. So the red tagged item can be stored in the red tagged area. For the wavering items, place a suspected item in the red tagged area for 1 week. If really it's not required, you can eliminate those things, or if you feel it is required, which can be brought back to workplace. Here the frequency of use also comes into picture. Some items may be very useful, and its frequency of usage may be higher. That kind of items are classified in this high priority items, probably once per day, that can be located at the workplace itself. Some of the items may be once per month or once per week, it may be useful. That item can be stored in an offline area. If some items may be a very less priority, it may require less priority, or if the frequency of use may be very less, once in a year or once in a 2 months, that items can be either thrown away from the workplace or stored away from the workplace, so that the items which are really required can be kept in front of you. The second S stands for Seiten, which is orderliness. Here, once you have eliminated all the unneeded items, turn to the leftover items, the required items. Organize layout of tools and equipments at designated locations. If you feel this item is regularly useful, you keep it in a place that can be easily accessible. And ensure everything is available as it is needed at the point of use. It should be available at your point of work. The third S stands for size, so we already know, which talks about cleaning and shining. Here we are going to create a spotless workplace. That means that there is no dirt at all. So we are going to eliminate the process of dirt. We are going to sweep, dust, polish and paint. And here the main idea is going to divide the work area into number of zones. One particular zone you can keep some items, the other particular area you can keep the rest of the items. Like you are going to create as a zones. Then you are going to assign responsibilities. Who has to clean this particular area? Who is in charge for the particular area? So that the tools and equipment must be owned by individuals. Here which leads to responsibility. Each and everyone is responsible for a particular area and particular equipments. The fourth S stands for circuitry, which is standardization. Here you are going to create a system that generates maintenance system for the first three phases. This phase includes development of procedures, schedules, and what are the practices to be followed has to be laid out. And you have to continue to assess this use and dispose of items. The next one is check sheet. It's a regularly audit using checklist and measure the housekeeping. The fifth phase is Shitsuki, sustain or discipline. Whatever we have followed, that should be improved upon. Or we have to sustain whatever the cleanliness we have maintained, that should be sustained. After a particular period of time, the emphasis may be lost, so the workplace once again going to be cluttered. So this should be avoided. So properly, we should sustain the environment. This talks about Shitsuki. Make it a way of life. Involve the whole workforce. You should teach all your workforce so that everyone will contribute in the workplace cleanliness. Develop and keep good habits. These are the 5 S's talks about cleanliness. We have a simple litmus test whether that particular organization really implemented 5 S or not. That litmus test talks about you should be able to locate any particular item within 30 seconds. Here it talks about 30 seconds rule. One must locate the item within 30 seconds if 5 S is properly implemented. If it is not properly implemented, you cannot locate the item within the stipulated period of time. As already told you, already listened, this particular process has number of advantages. The main thing is your area going to become uncluttered. The operators spend less time looking for items. They can very easily locate the item so that higher workstation efficiency can be achieved, which leads to mass production, and in turn Kaizen can be achieved, that is continuous process improvement can be achieved, and ultimately your industry becomes one of the lean industry. What you have come across at end of the day, these are some of the advantages if you implement properly the 5S principle. Neat and clean workplace, smooth working, you can read it upon. We have already discussed about these points. Now, we will have a small demonstration. This is the exercise for you. There are number of circles colored with different colors. Can you be able to tell me how many circles are there? How many colors are there? At each color, how many circles are there? Can you?
No.
In 10 seconds. It will be highly difficult.
The colors are
you can be able to tell only the colors only?
Yes.
Yes. If you implement the 5S, you can keep everything in a place. Everything has some place. Everything in its place. So here, whatever the circles I have drawn in the previous slides, I have organized and properly arranged that anybody can easily say how many circles are there. It is 9, 6, 6, 6 each, and the fifth one only 5 red circles. The red 11 color, 11 red color circles. Rest of the two colors are 12 each. So totally 35. It will be very easy to identify numbers and color. So I already told you, the 5S principle talks about a place for everything and everything in its place. 35 is the total number of balls, 12 is the blue color, 11 is the red color, and 12 is the orange color. Any missing? Yes, there is a missing, one red missing. Thank you for listening. I would like to come finish my talk by taking some quotes from Quran and Prophet Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad said, cleanliness is half of the faith. The Quran advocates, truly God loves those who turn unto Him in repentance and loves those who purify themselves. So, purity or cleanliness is part and parcel of everyone's life. Thank you for listening. Thank you.